Add the fractions. We have 3/5 plus 1/2. So let me draw a physical model of that. Okay, so this will be our 3/5. There's 1, 2, 3, and then plus 1/2. Then we'll shade in this. So here's our 1/2. Now, the 3/5 plus 1/2, we can't really combine these as is. They're different sizes, so we don't know how many total we have. So what we have to do is we have to continue to divide these up until we get a common size. And this is like finding a common denominator. So with 5 and 2, we need to find the least common multiple. And since they're both prime numbers, it's going to be 5 times 2, which is 10. So we need to divide into tenths. So here we have fifths, so to divide into tenths, we're going to cut one of these in half each time. So there we have tenths. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tenths shaded in here. So this is now 6 tenths. Notice it's the same size, you just divided everything in half. Now let's look at this 1/2, we need to divide it into tenths. So that means we need to divide each half 5 times. Okay, so now here we have tenths, and 5 of them are shaded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is now 5 tenths. Okay, so now we have 6 tenths plus 5 tenths. So if we add those together, it's going to be 11 tenths. Okay, so that's our answer. And let me show you how it looks if you're working with the fractions up here. You have 3/5, and to divide into halves, you have to times 2 over 2, and that makes 6 tenths. And with the 1/2, to change it to tenths, you need to multiply by 5, because 2 times 5 is 10. So this is going to be the same thing as 1/2 times 5 over 5 equals 5 tenths. So that gives you the 6 tenths plus the 5 tenths, and that's how you get the 11 tenths. So you can write your answer as 11 tenths as an improper fraction, or you could also put 1 and 1 tenth as a mixed number. Either way is correct. So you can put this or this.